Watch KSTV weeknights at 7:30 and 11 Eastern, and anytime with Insight on Demand on Channel 103.
And after UK won their eighth national championship in April, there was some discussion as to whether they were the greatest team of all time. But don't tell that to the 1996 squad who got together this weekend and gave their thoughts on how they match up.
I think when you look at 96, I think what made us stick together is, like I said, off the court things. When you have guys that actually care about each other, not numbers and about attitudes, because you see a lot of that take to the court, and you see guys don't want to pass each other. With us, we didn't care who scored. We didn't care who did what. We just wanted to win. And you have that. So, I mean, I'm not biased about 96 being a championship. CBS and everybody else got us one or two. So they can argue what they want to. We go by numbers. So, but it's great, man. But you have to have that unity. And that's what this even 2012 team, they stuck together even though they're freshmen and sophomores. They never gave up. They never gave up on one another, and that's why you win.
The 96 team would have, on paper, would have really, really beat us bad. But we had something special in 98, especially in the NCAA tournament. And so that's what is so hard to analyze, because you can't analyze that on paper. You can't put that on paper. And but in 96, you know, we were playing pretty good as well. I think the 96 team was one of the best in NCAA history. I'd put that team against anybody. I'd put them against the team, the 2012 Kentucky team. We had a way that year of closing down and stopping one great player, whether it was Keith Van Horn or Tim Duncan. We had a great game plan going against a great player. And but this year, I don't know which great player we would have tried to stop, but it's a fun conversation.
I think they're great. I think the thing about them that's a little different about us, they probably were 6'7" deep, not to take away from the other guys on the team, but we were 10'11" deep. Our depth would have really wore on them. We would have really wore them out. I think we put a lot of pressure on them as far as our depth-wise. But I'm not being biased. I don't think they were better than us. I think we were better than them and deeper than them. But I think what they accomplished this year at a young age is a tremendous feat. We had seniors, juniors. We had a little bit of everything, so it's kind of crazy.
What kept us winning was that, you know, we all came together for one common cause. That was to win a gold and win a championship. And everyone worked well with one another. You know, there wasn't any egos. And it's hard in a generation of really good players that everybody had to sacrifice. But it was, you know, it was for the better of the team. And Coach Pitino got the best out of all of us.
I mean, it's simple. We won by 21 points. They would win by 6 or 7. They have no pro players they're playing against. Now, mind you, if they were sophomores, juniors, and seniors, we could have a different discussion, and they got a bench. But when you play against a team like us, 86 points at halftime, 40 points on the road against pro players, what is there to argue? I mean, Davis is a great player. We leave him there, but he'd have to go through a whole lot of beating up to get Nazee Muhammad, Mark Pope, Walter McCarty. I mean, it goes on and on, but I love watching this team. I'm just glad we're part of the same family. I mean, Jack Givens won in 78, and I still remember that guy. I mean, 41 points. That was a horse. So, I mean, you give guys credit when it's due, and I'm just glad we're all part of the same championship.
You know, Mark, there are two types of people in this world. There's a group of people that believe the 2012 team could beat the 1996 team.
Yes.
And then there are people that are right.
Ouch.
So, as I understand, you are not one of the people that are right. You think the 2012 team was better than that group?
I just think in one game, I just feel like the weapons that Kentucky had, I know they're only 6 deep, but we're talking about one game, okay? I understand over a season, if you're playing 11 deep, that's fantastic. But I'm talking the 2012 team. They had so many weapons. They were so big and athletic. And I'm not saying 96 team wasn't. I just feel like they matched up well. And you can't just tell me that the 96 team would blow them out.
I didn't say they'd blow them out, but I think it's clear the 1996 team has more bodies. And Derek Anderson, I think, said it best when he was on here. He said that Michael Kidd-Gilchrist, Derek Anderson matchup may be a push. But Derek Anderson and Ron Mercer going at Michael Kidd-Gilchrist for 40 minutes, I think that's where depth comes into play. And if you look at that team, you know, obviously both groups, a lot of sacrifice. They were playing together as a group. But if you look at 96, that roster is loaded. You get down to, you know, Eloy Vargas minutes, and it's Nazee Muhammad playing Eloy Vargas minutes.
Yeah, you got it.
So
I'll take Eloy Vargas. I'm kidding.
But they're two special groups. And I think, you know, you look at the coaches, John Calipari and Rick Pitino, their whole lives have been kind of side by side in perception, not together. They don't, but people think of them kind of together because they were both good back then. They're both great right now. And they're both kind of larger than life personalities. John Calipari, 2012, Rick Pitino, 1996, who are you taking?
Well, here's what I'm going to say, is I believe that that UMass team only played about six or seven guys, and they gave that team a run for their money. And I feel like the team he had now in 2012 was better than that UMass team maybe. So I feel like they would give him a run for their money.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think John Calipari now,
His offense has changed now, but yeah. I feel you. I think he, with playing against Rick Pitino and his system, it's a totally different ball.
Yeah, and what he's doing recruiting-wise is, you know, you look at what UCLA did on that run. It's obviously a different time, but what he's doing right now is so special considering all the rules changes, the competition, the AAU, everything. I think what he's doing is special. And I look forward to spending more time with you today and making sure that you get on the right side of this argument.